Hello students, I am Pitamber Gadve. In this lecture we will see intensity of radiation. So term intensity of radiation is nothing but radiant heat flux emitted by the surface. So let us consider this is a surface which having area dA, and it emits the heat flux in this direction. Okay, so intensity of radiation is called as radiant heat flux emitted by this surface in a particular direction per unit solid angle. Okay, so radiant heat flux emitted by surface in a particular direction per unit solid angle. So let us understand this. This is the surface dA. When this surface dA emits the radiation in this direction, the direction is given by this zenith angle theta and this azimuth angle phi. Okay, so this into this particular direction, when radiation is emitted, radiant heat flux is emitted in this particular direction per unit this solid angle subtended by this is called as intensity of a radiation. So we can write intensity of radiation I is equal to radiant heat flux emitted in a particular direction divided by solid angle d omega. Okay, so let us rearrange this equation. Therefore dE is equal to I into d omega. dE is equal to I into d omega. Let us consider this is an emissive power. Let us consider this as a equation number 1. And when we integrate this equation over this whole sphere, we get emissive power of a surface. So when we integrate above equation over all directions encompassed by hemisphere, we get E is equal to, that is equation 1 becomes E is equal to integration of I into d omega. Okay, and I into d omega, we know value of d omega. D omega value is nothing but value of solid angle. So let us integrate this equation from zenith angle to the azimuth angle. So when we integrate this from zenith angle to the zenith angle, which is from 0 to pi by 2. Okay, so for zenith we have to integrate it from 0 to pi by 2, and for azimuth angle we have to integrate it from 0 to okay, so we have, sorry, for azimuth angle we have to integrate it by for 0 to 2 pi. Okay, let us integrate. Therefore E is equal to integration for zenith, so we can integrate for whole hemispherical object, so it is from 0 to pi by 2. Integration from 0 to twice pi, it is for azimuth, I into d omega. And we know value of d omega is equal to sine theta d theta into d phi. So let us put this value in this equation. We get E is equal to 0 to pi by 2 0 to 2 pi I into d omega is sin theta d phi. Let us consider this is equation number 2. Now, for many surfaces or it may be applied for many real surfaces also. For many surfaces, we have Lambert's cosine rule. Okay, that is Lambert's cosine rule. Lambert's cosine rule, which is Lambert's cosine rule is nothing but intensity of a radiation. Intensity of a radiation in any direction, intensity of radiation in any direction is proportional to the cosine angle made by that direction to the normal. We know this Lambert's cosine rule that gives us this intensity of radiation is proportional to cosine angle made by that direction with its normal. So this is normal. We know this is normal to the surface. This is normal to the surface, and intensity of radiation in this direction is nothing but cosine angle made by this direction with the normal. So we can write I is equal to intensity of radiation. This is I is equal to intensity of in a normal direction. Let us consider this is intensity in a normal direction. In into cos of angle theta. Into cos of angle theta. This is Lambert's cosine rule. Now we have to put this in equation number 2. So put in equation number 2. Put in equation 2. Equation 2. We get E is equal to emissive power is equal to integration from 0 to pi by 2 to integration from 0 to twice pi into I is nothing but In cos theta into sin theta d phi. Okay, so as we know this is In is constant, so take it outside. So In into integration from 0 to pi by 2, this is with respect to zenith angle. So we have term cos theta sin theta d theta, and integration from 0 to 2 pi, which is related to azimuth angle phi, so it is 1 into d phi. So let us integrate this term. We know this cos into sin, so here we can say sin square theta is equal to twice cos theta sin theta. This is a mathematical formula. So let us put this in equation. So we get E is equal to In integration from 0 to pi by 2. So when we put cos theta sin theta, it transfer to left hand side, it becomes sin square theta upon 2 into d theta. Into integration from 0 to pi, it is 1 into d phi. So let us simplify this integration now. So let us integrate. So E is equal to In into integration of sin square theta upon 2. Integration of sin square theta upon 2. That is equal to sin square theta upon 2. Is equal to from 0 to it is pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, and for azimuth angle it is 1 into 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so let us rearrange this equation. That is equal to in this 2 pi minus 0 means 2 pi, and we know sin square theta, when we put upper limit it becomes sin square pi by 2, and sin square pi by 2 is 1, so into 1 by 2 into this values, when we apply upper limit it becomes 2 pi, so this 2 2 gets cancelled, therefore E is equal to pi into in. Therefore, intensity in normal direction is given by emissive power upon pi. So this is intensity, this is very simple equation, intensity in normal direction is equal to E by pi.